In this video, I'm showing you how to do the manual mesh bed leveling using the Marlin firmware on your Anit A8 3D printer. Come and join me. Hello, my name is Daniel. Welcome to the Crosslink channel. On this channel, I post videos about 3D printing, gadget reviews, and more. And today we're covering how to do manual mesh bed leveling on the Anit A8 using the Marlin firmware. So as a prerequisite, I recommend watching my video about how to set up the Marlin firmware on your Anit A8. So go and watch it if you didn't yet. So as a disclaimer to this video, I just have to say that I'm doing this using the new display that we've added in the last video. So this makes our lives a little bit easier in terms of doing the manual mesh bed leveling is not a must-have. So let's briefly understand what normal bed leveling is versus mesh bed leveling. So normally you can just adjust your print bed's distance from the nozzle with the four corners, the four screws that you have, and you can do this manually. And the point is, you cannot adjust more points. You have no chance to cover the middle, for example. If the print bed has a slight curve, for example, you can have the print bed perfectly adjusted in the corners, but still in the middle, your nozzle will have, for example, a larger distance and it will not print correctly. And so the Marlin firmware has a feature that's called mesh bed leveling, and the manual process goes as follows. You will first start and manually adjust the print bed as I described it previously. So this is, let's say, a prerequisite. It should be aligned already in the corners, and then you will start using this feature and actually get 9 points. And so you can readjust in these 9 points the distance of the nozzle. The software remembers these points, and during the print it calculates basically the perfect distance anywhere where the nozzle just is, and this makes the prints much better sticking to the surface compared to just having four corners and four screws to adjust the distance. So that's it basically about what the mesh bed leveling is, and let's not start and walk through how to set it up. So assuming that you already flashed the Marlin firmware to your printer, so you have some experience how to do that and that it works on your printer, so I'm now going to walk you through the configuration changes needed to support the manual mesh bed leveling in the Marlin firmware. So let's start. Go to the Marlin configuration file and go to line number 980 roundabout. Though it depends, of course, on the version of the firmware that you use. I'm using 1.1.9, and here we find the setting that's called mesh bed leveling. So you have to uncomment that line. That enables the general feature, and there is another line which is 1102. So this setting enables the LCD bed leveling. That means you will get a new menu item on your LCD, on your printer's menu, to calibrate the mesh bed leveling using the printer menu. And finally, one setting that I want to mention is in line 986, there is a feature that's called Restore Leveling After G28. So just to remind you, G28 is a command that homes your printer. So it's basically done every time a new print starts. And what this feature does is it loads the stored settings of the mesh bed leveling from the EEPROM and uses them in the print. And if you don't enable this feature, you will have to do a separate G code, which is M420S. It's also in the documentation. I've linked it in the description down below. It says in the documentation of the Marlin firmware, you have the choice of using M420S before you start printing to load the settings, or you can use this feature Restore Leveling After G28. So it's up to you what you want. So I would go now and enable Restore Leveling After G28 because I want to print out some old files basically that don't have these initial G codes, the M420. So after configuring the firmware and uploading it to your printer, we can now start using the manual mesh bed leveling. So first of all, we need to heat up everything, the printer nozzle and the heat bed, to everything to be expanded to the normal printing situation. And you should consider that different temperatures and different materials could require a recalibration of the bed leveling. So if we use PLA and then afterwards we start using ABS, we would have a higher temperature on the bed, and then we would have to do the mesh bed leveling again before we can actually use it. So let's walk through the process. Let's first heat up the printer and say prepare and preheat for PLA. So let's wait for the temperature to come up and then go to the prepare menu. And then we'll see we have the new menu item here, which is called bed leveling. Go to level bed. Printer is going now to home its position, and we can start immediately when it says click to begin. So let's click now. So the printer nozzle moves to the first corner. I'm using my piece of paper and check whether the distance is fine, and it feels good. So let's move on to the next point. Okay, so here I have the feeling, okay, maybe it's a little bit close. I have too much resistance. I'm going to give it more distance. So a positive value means you're a little bit further away from the heat bed. And if you think, okay, this is the same kind of resistance that I had in the previous point, I'm going to hit the button again. And it's moving to the next corner. And here, since I have now set the positive value to 200, it's probably too far here. And now let's go down again and check that the distance is fine. So this feels right, and hit the button again. And so we're going to repeat this for all the corners, and at the end of the process, I can save the values. Okay, so now the leveling is done. One thing you shouldn't forget is to actually save the settings by using the store settings, and it gives you a confirmation. And that means now, okay, the settings are basically in the EEPROM, and because we enabled to restore the settings on the G28, so the Autohome, every time a print starts, now it's going to use these settings. One thing that I wanna point out here is they had some issues when doing the first round of mesh bed leveling. I discovered that my set and stop switch was hit, and you can hear this if it's clicking while you're trying to turn the knob or getting the nozzle down, you will be stopped. Basically, it will not go down further. And that means you will have to adjust using the knobs, the print bed to be closer to the nozzle. And after finishing the round, you will have to redo it again. Because if you change anything during the mesh bed leveling, if you change any of the distance knobs, the whole process has to repeat it. And so that's what I had to do. And my quick tip here is also have a little bit more pressure in the beginning. So do you have some room to play? That doesn't really hurt. And that helped me to fix this problem. So now we can do a test print and use our new settings and new values that we have just calibrated and see what the results are. You will find the link to the STL file for the calibration print in the description down below. So if you find that after printing out the test print, for example, you think that you would need more pressure to the heat bed, you don't have to go all over the mesh bed leveling again. You can adjust the overall distance for every point in one central place. You just have to go to the prepare menu and to the bed leveling menu, and here you have one item that's called bed Z, and that means this can help to decrease or increase the distance for the whole plane, even if it's like curved, it doesn't matter. And so you can bring the nozzle closer or further away with this setting, so that should help. So this is the end of the video. I hope you liked it, so please hit the like button if so. Also consider subscribing to my channel and also hit the bell if you want to get notified every time I post a new video. So if you want, we can see each other next week on this channel for another video about 3D printing, gadget reviews and more. Have a good week. Bye bye.